Joanne Bates, Tanya Brown, Sonia Nicholson, the Stooges. Good day and welcome to the State House. So nice to see you all. And I hope you've enjoyed your stay over the last couple of days. Now, they say welcome to sunny Fiji, certainly not sunny Suva, this part of the country. Now, we're looking forward to some lovely sunny days. We had a lot of rain over the last couple of days. So I hope that you enjoy your stay in the village. It's not too wet. But, hopefully the weather will clear up for you even in the week. Now, on behalf of myself and the rest of the your friends here, relatives, see Mr. Kwanagat. So nice to see you all. I've been looking forward to the visit because of the fact that you are the first overseas school to visit the State House since I took over as president. I have heard a brief about the overview of the place, why we're here and what we do. And I believe you've been to Parliament. Parliament's organization. And I hope that the Secretary has briefed you about what parliamentarians do. No different from your parliament in Canada. You are here, according to my brief, to have a little country. And it's not the first time that you had visitors from your school. Now, and you're here to assist the students of the Memorial Village School, who hopefully will come across the Tasmania in some stage in the future. And you hosted one or two visits before, and this is a sister school relationship that we would like to nurture and promote further for the sake of our students who may not have an opportunity to leave our shores to come and visit Australia. Now, when you come to Fiji, Fiji is a very small place compared to Tasmania, or even Australia for that matter. Now, when I address school children here in Fiji, I keep reminding them that you are the future of our countries. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the teachers and the chaperones, who I pray for them there, for accompanying the kids to come. It is not easy for you to fundraise or to get yourself organized for the kids, your families, mom and dad, and the rest of your siblings, and to come across to a different country. When I was told that you were in Fiji, I thought that you were down one of the hotels in town. I didn't realize that you are in the village. I hope you're not too badly beaten by the monsters. I say this because of the fact that most of us, or some of us, grew up in the village. Not all my stuff grew up in the village. A lot of them grew up in the towns. They used the luxury of the towns. For those of us who grew up in the villages, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, enjoy the rest of your stay, and I certainly hope that you learn a lot about Fiji. And about our people. It's always nice to have young students like you visit our country. And I hope that what you learn during your short visit to Fiji will benefit you later on in life as you return to your country. Spent a lot of time in Australia as a student. As a former soldier, I worked in the military for many years. And as a former Fijian high commissioner in Canberra, I spent a lot of time in Canberra. Despite the rain, it's certainly warm in Tasmania at the moment, I'm shooting back. So when you do get back home, I hope the weather's not going to be too cold for you. The good thing about Fiji, it rains a lot, but it's warm. And as a farmer, and I'm talking to you about gardening later on, and I'm glad because, you know, I did a lot of rain for my crops, which I have back here somewhere. You heard about my traditional role that I gave a statement. I championed backyard gardening. I've been talking to the gentleman who mentioned, I'm talking about backyard farming. And food security for you young ones is very important. Australia provides a lot of meat and a lot of other commodities for the rest of the world. And a bigger country, bigger economy, small country like Fiji, you kind of people for the rest of the world. Hands up if you're going to take support and do your own things. I know you will start. Have you done, sir? No, no. Good enough. Good enough. Now, I've come to my second topic, because now you've been from the sector, you have the chief advocate in terms of the body of wellness and keeping fit. I have been reminding my team, as the president, head of state, I want to lead by example. So this morning, I'm not sure what time to get out of here, but you know, as he was still asleep, I took my team for a 5-kilometer run, and I leave the gym, and we, but there are not too many people out here because of the rain. But I can assure you that we enjoy walking and running in the rain. So I champion the fight against NCDs, and I'm sure you're aware of the fact that NCDs are not very nice. I think they are not high blood pressure and diabetes. And sadly, for a country like PG, we spend a lot of time and money living out our sick people, and still there are bad choices in life. And for a small economy like the EU, when government spends about $400 billion every year to looking after our sick people through NCD-related ailments, that's a lot of money that could be channeled back to education and to other sectors in the innovation without our schools back and forth as the young developing nation. So I'm very concerned and very disappointed about some of the statistics which I read on a daily basis. So, and I alluded to, I believe in being the example of good health to the nation. And that's why my team and I decided to have the impact of our own food. So when I go around the country talking to people about people, I've been self-sufficient in our terms of finding their own food. We walk the court. I will remind the members of the nation that we run the court. Walk the ship's moving. And we will walk. Now, we need some family advice of that part that I have a better part. For you young ones, remain focused and committed with your studies. Listen to your parents, listen to your teachers. We view the world that we face with many challenges on a daily basis. Here we see in our social media the big problems. I'm sure the same with you, but I'll leave it at that. Don't spend too much time on a daily basis. Study well, study hard. And use the time to do other things. Another issue that I'd like to remind you young people, here in PG, substance abuse is a big problem for our young people, and no one here. Our police and some of our other agencies are having a problem in trying to police and make sure that things don't get out. I know that my belief is I'm very proud of you that as a Christian school, you promote and approach a lot of principles and values which we all share as Christians. And that is very good. I say that because I sent all my grandchildren to teach the school in Fiji. And I would say to show my children, it's the same thing. Fiji to the young people of the nation. As the president of the state, I'm very much guided by terms of reference. My mandate under the Constitution, as you heard from the Secretary, are the people of the national unity. My job, my proper role is to defend the United States. Now, Fiji is unique, it's not like Australia in many respects. We had our problems, but I've been telling our leaders and members of the community that we should learn from our past mistakes and make sure we what a challenge that made for us as a young developing nation. One thing that I found as a soldier, as a diplomat now, as a head of state, something that the United Nations has schools, talking about schools for motivation from the Arab European and Europeans. Only just the report in next. And when we meet the bodies, wish the bodies to well for the rest of the world. Our team and some of the teams are happy to be good at last week. I feel not. We love it when we think directly is like a religion. When our national team wins, we celebrate, we even have national holidays. But when we lose, television sets go out the window and there's a lot of moaning, groaning and consolation that arrives on that. But such is life. We always value our relationship with Australia. For your information I just received note from your president, from the general, to the former military colleague of mine. Just let me. Does anybody know the thing? I'll ask it to you. It was just taken over from General Pascoe, who was a former company general, who retired 2 months ago. The present company general of Korea is General King Philip. And now the soldier. But I'll just finish paying a quick note to him. Wishing him well for the rest of his tenure as the governor of Australia. And to answer your question, sir, about my term, under our constitution, I have a term of 3 years. I was sworn in for the first time, and you've heard about the fact that I'm the first president of this nation to be appointed. By our government, and I have to be a term inspired, I used to term inspired the end of last year, so I have an extension until the end of 2021. So, whether it's a yes or a no, I need to have an extension to really depend on the government. And that's the term of the Constitution. My family and I live in Greece. We come from Ireland, not North. People are away from here. Next time we come, we will talk to each other from Greece and Greece and Ireland. See where I'm home now. Yes. So I thought about 4 years ago, sir. And I look forward to my term serving the nation well. I'd like to once again thank you. Thank you. this institution we return to all the thanks for choosing to be in Syria. And we hope to meet this situation where we are to this. I've been sure that we have a campaign somewhere. We call it one of our most local places that we don't have to stand. We pray to go around, hold your day. Sadly, we have to think about what we have in the world, because the moment we should put it up on the inside, excuse me. I don't know if we have to go down to the day, but I don't think the day of next day we will have to go down. On behalf of my team, sometimes the family, and to watch the world of the family, we should be safe today, I think that we are going to be able to do it. I'm going to see you all. I'm going to see you all.